My name is Larissa Tormi. I'm a singer-songwriter based in Ireland, originally from Russia. And my mission is to introduce you to as many as possible talented musicians in my music and my story show. I'm welcoming to my show Norman Boland from Ireland and his first song, Three Wooden Crosses.
A farmer and a teacher, a hooker and a preacher, riding on the midnight bus bound for Mexico. One was headed for a vacation, one for higher education. Two of them were searching for lost souls. That driver never ever saw the stop sign. An 18-wheeler can't stop on a dime. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That farmer left a harvest, a home in 80 acres, faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. That teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children, did her best to give them all a better start. That preacher whispered, can't you see the promised land? As he laid his blood-stained Bible in that hooker's hand. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That's a story that our preacher told last Sunday, as he held that blood-stained Bible up for all of us to see. He said, bless the farmer and the teacher and the preacher. Give this Bible to my mama who read it to me. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, now I guess we know. It's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of highway.
Hello, my name is Norman Borland, and I'm a country music singer from Donegal. My background, I was late starting music. I didn't start music till I was probably about 15, 16 years ago. So I was in my sort of 50s before I started singing. No, it wasn't late 40s, early 50s, and I joined a band just as a rhythm guitarist and backing vocals. And then I got the hunger, as it were, to start doing my own thing, and I really wanted to record an album. That was what we wanted to do, because I thought, well, it's always going to be there forever, you know. It's kind of taken over my life a little bit. It's like a niche that you could never scratch. I just like my music, you know, and my love is country music. I don't do anything other. I did an album 2 years ago, I've done four. I think it's four or five singles now, as you say, coming off. But I'm almost finished another album, so I only have one or two more tracks to do, and then that's another album finished. So I record them at the Harmony Recording Studios up here in Letterkenny with a great guy called Brian Kerrigan, and he really does go all out to make sure that you're happy and the way we do things and we talk about things. And, you know, because some places you go to and they record you and then you have to accept what they give you. He will not finalize things until you are there. That's what I like. The plan will be, you know, hopefully when things start to lift, that we can get back to some kind of normality, you know. And I'm too old now to do the sort of dance scene, but, you know, I want to do the concert scene and, you know, Cabaret festivals and stuff like that. You can interact more with your audience when you're doing a concert than if you're on a dance. You know, people get carried away with the beat and with the music and such like. But I think people get more attached to you if you're singing a song, because every country song has got story, you know, and it's nice to tell a story in that song. And I think it's nice, you know, whether it's a ballad, whether it's an upbeat song or whatever it is, it still has a story. What we've got at the moment is a duet that I've done with Jerry Guthrie.
Ain't No Little Thing, new duet from Norman Borland and Jerry Guthrie.
You're wondering where this romance leads. Speaking from my heart comes hard for me. So I tried to find what I feel, but this time it's too big to conceal. This ain't no little thing that I can do without. Not some plain about. Ain't no kiss and run, not some casual fling. There's no doubt, darling, love ain't no little thing. Passion roars like a big freight train, rolling through my heart, rumbling through my
our latest single, and it's doing very, very well for us. I must admit, Ain't No Little Thing it's called. And you know, I want to thank everybody out there for requesting it and playing it on the radio station. It's been absolutely brilliant.
One of the most popular latest songs by Norman Bolan featuring Mick Flavin, Little Mountain Church.
There's a little mountain church and my thoughts of yesterday, where friends and family gathered for the Lord. There an old-fashioned preacher taught the straight and narrow way for what few coins the congregation could afford. Dressed in all our Sunday best, sat on pews of solid oak, I remember how our voices filled the air. And Mama sounded like an angel on those high soprano notes. When the roll is called, yonder I'll be there. Looking back now, that little mountain church house has become my life's cornerstone. It was there in that little mountain church house I first heard the words based my life upon. Souls that were revived, while the brothers and the sisters who'd gone on to glory land slept in peace in the maple grove nearby. Looking back now, that little mountain church house has become my life's cornerstone. It was there in that little mountain church house the words I based my life upon. Looking back now, that little mountain church house has become my life's cornerstone. It was there in that little mountain church house I first heard the words I based my life upon. I first heard the words I based my life upon.
Mick Flavin, an absolute gentleman, you know, and he would be one of my favorites in the Irish country music scene, because yeah. he's 100% country, you know. Jerry's a lovely guy too, you know, and we worked so well together, which was absolutely brilliant. And but the duet I did with Mick, you know, it sort of had a bit of a gospel theme to it as well, you know, and it turned out a fantastic song. Did very well for us. I'm doing a live gig with the full band on the 19th of June from the Civil Arts Centre in Oma. And my guest artist that night is Patricia McGuire.
see my boy in old Caroline. I'll drink my booze and do as I please for all those boys I long to squeeze. Singing the song, my Dixie darling, that's where I long to be going down, where the jelly roll's rolling with my Dixie dream. My Dixie darling, listen to the song I sing beneath the silver moon with my banjo right in tune. My heart is ever true.
Norman, our listeners like to hear some very interesting, fun story from your music experiences.
Festival a few years ago in Thurso, which is right up the north of Scotland. And I actually learned something there that I've stayed in my mind all this time. We were on with an American band, and they had missed their slot for a sound check. The Derailers was the name of the band. Mm-hmm. Lovely guy. I've kept in touch with them, you know, and they were late coming for their sound check. And whenever they came to go on, the sound man went up to them and said to them, "Sorry guys, you know, you weren't here for your sound check. We're going to have to go through it." And the lead singer, which I thought was an absolute cracker, he said, "Hell man, we don't need no sound check. We're musicians."
And to keep spirits up, I'm going to finish my show with my own track, "Why Don't You Love Me?"
Well, why don't you love me like you used to do? How come you treat me like a worn-out shoe? My hair's still curly and my eyes are still blue. So why don't you love me like you used to do? And hard no loving like a hugging and a kissing in a long, long while. We don't get nearer, further or closer than a country mile. So why don't you spot me like you used to do? Says with nothing's like you used to could. I'm the same old trouble that you've always been through. So why don't you love me like you used to do? Why don't you be just like you used to be? Find so many faults with me. Somebody's changed, so let me give you a clue. Why don't you love me like you used to do? Ain't hurt not loving like a hugging and a kissing in a long, long while. We don't get nearer, further or closer than a country mile. So why don't you say the things you used to say? What makes you treat me like a piece of clay? My hair's still curly and my eyes are still blue. So why don't you love me like you used to do? Why don't you love me like you used to do? How come you treat me like a worn-out shoe? My hair's still curly and my eyes are still blue. So why